Hello, welcome back to Health and Human Rights Strategies YouTube channel. I'm Nicole, the founder and president of HHR. Today, we're going to talk about rejection and physical pain and how they're almost the same to your brain. Rejection hurts. Whether you've been told no thank you for a job opportunity, become estranged from a partner or friend, or even been unfollowed on social media or a dating site, your brain has to process being rejected. And neuroscience suggests that it literally hurts. Although the brain does not process emotional pain and physical pain identically, research on neural pathways suggests there is substantial overlap between the experience of physical and social pain. So stick around to learn more, and be sure to click that subscribe button so that you can get all of our updates. Let's get right into how physical pain and social rejection are processed by your brain. First, the cascading events that occur and the regions activated in our brains, and therefore our reactions to the acute pain, appear to be very similar. Further, it seems the impact may not be limited to just how the brain processes the emotions and pain associated with rejection, but that real heartbreak can actually take a toll on our IQ. You see, according to research from Case Western Reserve University, exposure to rejection led participants in a study to have an immediate drop in reasoning by 30% and a drop in IQ by 25%. Thus, a broken heart really does hurt, and it can take a while to heal. So what exactly is going on in your head and your heart? Because humans are social creatures by nature, heartbreak, loss, and the feelings that are associated with being left out are particularly difficult for us to process. And because emotional wounds are invisible, anguish, distress, and stress can be difficult to understand. And they can also be really difficult to explain to our peers. However, social rejection from potential partners and online activities are becoming more and more commonplace. Thus, we are now rejected frequently, but with small snubs like unfollowing on Twitter, swiping left on Tinder, not receiving likes on an Instagram post, or maybe it's not matching on a dating site or being alone for the holidays. But these emotions can now be felt often because of our connectivity online. You see, social media and constant contact to millions of people at any moment can often mean further personal distance with our connections. And online activity gives us more opportunity for small rejection, even if it's as simple as not liking a picture on Instagram. Research out of the University of Michigan suggests that not only does the brain process rejection like it does physical injury, but that personality traits like resilience are vital to how we process the pain. The brain's natural painkilling response varies between humans, with some releasing more opioids during social rejection than others, meaning that some people have a stronger or more adaptive protective ability. When mu opioid is released, there's actually a trigger in two specific areas of the brain. One processes the strength of the emotion, and the other determines how your mood changes because of the event. Therefore, the more opioid released, the greater reduction in pain, and possibly a greater experience of pleasure that someone may feel when they've been socially accepted or validated. Similar to results from physical pain studies, researchers have also found that the anterior cingulate cortex, or ACC, and the right ventricle prefrontal cortex were far more active when feeling loss or exclusion. And the greater one's anxiety, the greater the activity in the ACC. However, a systematic review published in Brain Imaging and Behavior concluded that the neural network for psychological pain includes many different parts of the brain, suggesting there's a deeply complex and interconnected series of regions that process and express pain. Additionally, thanks to functional MRI studies, it's also possible to now see the neural overlap, both in how we process and experience pain, emotional and physical. That said, work at both Dartmouth and the University of Colorado Boulder reveals that there are in fact two distinct brain patterns for processing pain if you can get granular enough. With enough future work in pain management, these researchers hope to really tease out the differences so that we can personalize treatment plans in the future. So, what are we to do if we feel slighted by those we love or rejected in a social situation? First, based on all the things we've talked about, realize you're probably taking it too personally. That's not a knock to you. It's just a product of how humans think. We think about ourselves more than anyone else does. In fact, almost 80% of your thoughts are about yourself. So, in this fast-paced world with a million distractions, chances are the slight really wasn't personal. Second, understand that we're all basically using a triaging system, and it puts our most important to-do items and our closest connections first. It could therefore be as simple as someone hasn't seen your interaction or your post. There's also so many feeds flooding people at any given moment that their brain triages. There are also individual and demographic differences in how people interact. Lots of people go on social media and they scroll through pictures, but they don't actually interact with anyone else. Third, it's important to remember that we recall emotional rejection more strongly than physical pain, and it can therefore cause longer-term sensitivity. When this happens, seek out validation and reminders of the positive impact that you have on others. Go talk to someone who you know cares about you. During the holidays, this can mean making proactive plans with friends or reaching out to those we love but have often been too busy to connect with. Get to know them better. Most importantly, it is critical to allow the negative feelings to be respected and processed, but try not to assign too much value to them. Remember, they will subside, and our bodies will cope with emotional rejection over time, just like it does physical pain.